Welcome back, everyone. This is, I think, the best part of the day where we get to meet a lot of students and a wonderful teacher and a wonderful coach. So we have the live masterclass right now by Yogita Bhardwaj. Yogita completed her master's in English and BA when she realized her vision would be best served by working with children who do not have the access to quality education. This realization prompted her to join the fellowship in 2018 and work tirelessly to create significant change in the first year intervention classroom. When her fellowship came to an end, she decided that her work was still not done and chose to carry on as a TTF fellow to continue bringing a positive change in the school and community. Welcome, Yogita, and welcome, wonderful students. We also have Emma. All of you might have seen Emma yesterday. Emma is back here again. Emma will do the debrief with Yogita after the lesson to understand more about the class. What is she thinking? Why is she doing this lesson? So that's a point of debrief. Yogita and Emma and dear students, over to you for the next 45 minutes.
Thank you so much, Ellie. Okay, let me share my screen with you quickly. Okay. Welcome, Shernees. Welcome to your masterclass. And before we begin our class, I quickly want you to write it on the chat. How is your heart doing today? Happy. Okay. Thank you so much, Kanishka, for sharing. Excited. Thank you, Manisha, for sharing that. Excited. Excited. Proud. Excited. Cheerful. Feeling cherry merry. Excited and joyful. Okay. Great. Thank you so much for sharing. Nikita, can you come off mute and can you share with us? How are you feeling? How is your heart doing today? Babu, I can't hear you. Nikita, I can't hear you. Okay, Nikita, can you pull out your earphones from the phone and then maybe you can try speaking? Yeah, I can hear you now.
My heart is doing happy, excited, and cheerful.
Great. Thank you so much, Nikita, for sharing. Nancy, how is your heart doing today?
Didi, my heart was doing today very happy and excited.
Great. Very happy and excited. Thank you so much for sharing. Didi is also feeling very excited and very proud of you. So let's start our class by doing an activity with all of you. Okay. And the name of the activity is Spin a Yarn. So what are we going to do in this activity is that I gave you a pre-work. The story was the magic letter. Okay. And I asked you to read the story and write down the events that you have read and understood from the story. So what are we going to do right now is one person will start off by sharing what happened in the story. And then we will share one by one, like the first event, Didi, this happened. The second event, Didi, this happened. And we will share it with all of us. Okay. Can Priya repeat what I said? What are we doing right now?
Didi, we are going to do one activity, opening activity. In that, it's been a yarn. In that, you have given us a pre-work. So we have to share the story we have read.
Great. So we are going to share the events that we made notes, right? Okay. So Lakshmi, can you please tell me the first event of the story?
The first event is Ijaz and Vikram are best friends. They live in different cities.
Great. Thank you so much. Can Vaishnavi quickly tell me the second event? What happened after this?
Yes. Earlier, they were neighbors. They liked playing cricket, solving riddles, and eating biryani. They did everything together.
Great. Thank you so much, Vaishnavi, for that. I can see you are using your notes to answer your question, to answer the events. Anya, can you tell me what happened after this?
As Vikram moved away, he sent letter to Ijaz, which had puzzle in them.
Great. Thank you so much, Anya, for sharing. Shreya, can you quickly share what happens after this in the story? Shreya Babu, you're on mute. Please unmute.
Didi, can you say again?
I'm asking, can you tell us what happens after this in the story? What happens after this?
Didi,
Okay, Shreya, let's come back to you. Okay, abhi hum sunenge and then we will come back. Arpita, can you share what happens after this in the story?
When Aziz opens the letter, he sees that the letter was blank.
Yeah, so the letter was blank. And now what happens? Manisha, can you tell us what happens after he saw that the letter was blank? Manisha, beta, can you hear me? Okay, I think there is some problem. It's okay. Ridhima, can you please share what happens?
He tried to read the letter in different ways, but nothing happened.
Great. Thank you so much, Ridhima, for that. And then what happens is that he tries a lot. He tries a lot in figuring out what he has to do with the letter. He sees the letter, he reads the letter, and after reading the letter, he finds a clue. Usko ek clue milta hai letter mein. And then he goes back to the us clue mein ek jagah likhi hoti hai, and he goes back to that place. Right. So what we did just now, humne events ko... Yes, Manisha?
Now I can hear you.
Yeah, okay, beta. There must be some network problem. No problem. Okay, so what we did just now, that Didi, with help of, we all of us together, we described the events of the story, right? We know what is happening. Story, when we read the story, hame pata chala story mein ho kya raha tha, right? And based on this, we will now think that how the story will end. We only know events ye hua, ye hua, ye hua. But abhi story end kaise hogi? We don't know that, right? Hame ending nahi pata. So, and this is what is the objective of today, that we will describe events and write an ending for a story by making predictions. So, Amir, can you read the meaning of prediction that is written?
Prediction, what will happen next?
Great. So, thinking what will happen next. I read the story. Jaise humne the magic letter story padhi. After reading that story, now Didi is thinking, this has happened, ye ho chuka hai, right? Based on those events, Didi will think, ki ab kya hoga? Didi is thinking, okay? This is what our objective for today is. Now, again, the question is, how Didi? Karna kya hai? Okay, so let Didi show you. So first is, Didi is going to give you an example. Example from the same story, the magic letter. Okay, we have already read it in our pre-work. So we saw and we read how Vikram had sent letters to Ijaz, right? And Ijaz has read the letter. Ijaz also found the clue and he went to that place jahan par usko jana tha, jo address tha. Now, ab Didi is wondering what will happen next. Ijaz pahunch gaya wahan pe. Right, Ijaz has reached that place and Didi is now thinking, but what is going to happen next? Piyu, do you want to ask anything? Piyu, you are raising your hand, beta. Are you on mute?
Didi, I want to tell answer.
You want to tell answer? Okay. First look what Didi is doing right now and then you can answer later. Okay, thank you, Piyu. So Didi is thinking that abhi kya hoga? Matlab Ijaz has reached the place. So what Didi is going to think? But Didi is also thinking ki story padhne ke baad, right? After reading the story, Didi ko kuch cheezein already pata hai. That aisa hua hai, this event happened and this event happened. So based on those events, Didi is thinking maybe, matlab I think Ijaz will find a new clue. Wo jis bhi address pe gaya hai, wahan pe usko ek new clue milega. न्यू क्लू में एक और लेटर होगा, एक और पजल होगी एंड वो पजल सॉल्व करने के बाद मे बी उसको उसका गिफ्ट मिल जाए जो विक्रम ने उसको भिजवाया है. So Didi is thinking this could also be possible, right? But, Didi is sorry about this. I don't know what's happening. This happens in our class, so it's fine. Okay, give Didi a minute, okay? Okay, it's opening. This one. Can you see my screen? Can you show me a thumbs up if you can see my screen? Great. Okay. So now, Didi ne event soche. Event sochne ke baad, Didi ne prediction socha. That, you know, this is happening. This could have happened. But Didi is also thinking, event soch liye, but wo kyun hoga? Why will that happen? So Didi is thinking, because story mein jo events tha, स्टोरी में इवेंट्स में दिस वॉज मैं राइट दैट इजाज को पजल सॉल्व करना बहुत पसंद था और विक्रम उसको लेटर्स में पजल्स भेजता था. दैट इज वाई दीदी ने जो स्टोरी का प्रिडिक्शन और एंड किया वो इस बेसिस पे किया बिकॉज दे बोथ लव्ड इन सेंडिंग पजल्स एंड वन लव्ड इन सॉल्विंग द पजल राइट. सो दिस वॉज फॉर वन स्टोरी. ठीक है, एक स्टोरी के लिए ये हमने सोचा. नाउ अगर हमें इफ वी हैव टू डू फॉर डिफरेंट डिफरेंट स्टोरीज देन हाउ कैन वी डू इट. आई वॉन्ट पीहू टू रीड दिस. पीहू कैन यू रीड द स्टेप्स बेटा?
यस दीदी.
या कैन यू रीड द फर्स्ट स्टेप?
थिंक अबाउट द इवेंट्स ऑफ द स्टोरी.
ओके पीहू बेटा एक सेकेंड वन मिनट. सो वी हैव टू थिंक. जैसे दीदी ने सोचा इवेंट्स क्या क्या हुए थे. वॉट वर द इवेंट्स दैट हैपेंड इन द स्टोरी? दीदी थॉट अबाउट दैट. So first is thinking about the events that happened in the story, right? Pew, can you read the second part?
What can happen after this?
Yeah. So Didi thought about all the events and Didi then thought that, okay, so this has happened. Now what will happen after this? Didi is thinking about the events. Yes, Pew, last one, please.
Why will the story end like this?
So why I'm going to end my story like this? I mean, what is the connection? What are the jo bhi events ho rahe hain? Like, what are the events that are happening in the story? And what I'm predicting? Are they connected? Kya usme koi connection hai? I have to think about that also, right? I request somebody who has not spoken. Kashish. Kashish, can you please read these three steps once again for me? If you can hear me, beta.
Yes, beta.
Please read the steps.
First is think about the events of the story. And okay. Second is what can happen after this. And third is why the story end like this.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Kashish, for doing this for me. So girls, beautiful. Now, what are we going to do right now is we are going to practice this. Okay. So first, in the large group, here only, we will read this passage. Okay. We will read this passage and someone is not on mute. So can I please request Himani, beta? Thank you for doing this. Okay. Didi forgot. Yeah. Yaad aa gaya. So in the practice time, what are we going to do? We are going to read this passage in the large group. Okay. First thing, hum sabse pehle kya karenge? We are going to pick out the main events. What are the main events in the story? Okay. I request Divya to repeat what are we doing right now.
So we are going to practice a paragraph and we read the paragraph, then we think the end of story.
Great. And how we will do this? We will write it. Okay. Writing an end of the story by making predictions. Okay. Thank you so much, Divya, for doing that. I request Khushi to read this passage for all of us. Khushi Babu, you are on mute. Khushi, beta, I can't. Huh. Khushi, can you try to pull out the wire from your phone? It's okay, Khushi.
Lion was once sleeping in the jungle when a mouse started running up and down his body just for run. This disturbed the lion, disturbed the lion sleep, and he woke quite angry. Woke up quite angry. He was about to eat the mouse when the mouse desperately.
Okay, Khushi, it's desperately.
Requested the lion to set him free. I promise you, I will be of great help to someday if you save me. The lion laughed at the mouse confidence and let him go.
Khushi beta ruko. Thank you so much for reading, Khushi. Now I request someone else to read it. So I want Kanishka, can you read it for all of us?
Yes, Didi. One day a few hunters came into the forest and to the lion. With them they tied him up against a tree. The lion was struggling to get out and started to
whimper.
Soon the mouse walked past, not noticed the lion in trouble.
Great. Thank you so much, Kanishka, for reading. Now, quickly, we are going to pick out the events. Okay. So, you can raise your hands if you already know. I mean, after this, if you already know what are the events that are happening. So, can somebody quickly tell me what is the first event happening? Ridhima, what is the first event happening?
The first event is that a lion is sleeping.
That the lion is sleeping. Great. Okay. Priyanshi, can you quickly tell me what is the happening, like the second event? I mean, you can take your time. Priyanshi, beta, can you hear me?
Yes, Didi.
Yes. Can you please tell me what is the second event?
Mouse disturbed the lion's sleep.
Okay. So the lion was sleeping and mouse disturbs the sleep of the lion. What, Anya, what's happening next? Anya, beta, you are on mute. You are not on mute, but please put the speaker near you.
Didi.
Just a minute, Kanishka. Let her finish, please. Yes, Anya.
Didi, I was not.
Okay.
The lion was woke up and quiet.
Okay, so the lion woke up and he was angry. Okay. Manisha, what happens after this?
He was about to eat the mouse.
Great. Okay. Nancy, what happens after this?
The mouse requested the lion to don't eat me. I will help you in the next mission.
Great. So the mouse requested, please don't kill me. I will help you whenever you will be in trouble. Okay. What happens after this, Pihu?
Didi, the lion laughed, but the mouse was very confident.
Okay, so the lion was laughing, but the mouse was confident. Okay, beautiful. Now, Lakshmi, can you tell me what happens after that?
Yes. Then, one day, few hunters come.
Babu, you don't have to read the text. You have to tell me from this paragraph what is the main event you are figuring out.
The One day, hunters come and they take the lion.
Great.
Take the lion with them.
They take the lion. So hunters come and they take the lion. Okay, Ritima, what happens after that? They take the lion. After that, what happens? Anamika, just a minute, beta. Please, 1 minute, ruk jao. Thank you so much, Anamika. Yes, Ritima, can you share?
Yeah, Didi.
So what happens after they took the lion with them, with him?
They tied him. 1 second.
Okay, meanwhile, Ritima is reading. Soumya, can you tell us what happens after this event? Soumya, can you hear me? Okay, it's okay. Kashish, Didi, can you tell us? Yeah, Ritima, please go ahead.
Yeah, Didi, they tied the lion. Jo lion tha, usse tree pe latka diya.
Great. Okay. So now, and quickly finishing this, and the lion was very struggling to come out of it, right? And mouse saw that the lion was tied against the tree. So these were the events. Ye sab hua abhi story mein, right? So we know the events. Now quickly we will go into our breakout rooms and few kids will stay with Didi. Yahan par few kids will stay with Didi in the main room. And we will discuss how you would like to end your story. Okay? And you will have to give reason also why you are going to end your story in that way. Okay? So in the breakout room, you will discuss what will happen next in the story. Abhi kya hoga story mein next? Why will the story end like this? And you will have 5 minutes to do this. Okay? So we will quickly go into our breakout rooms, quickly come with the end of the story, and we'll have a reason. So events and predictions, connections banana hai hame, okay? Okay, we will come back in 8 minutes. Okay, take your time. We will come back in 8 minutes. Thinking time, 8 minutes. Okay. Arpita Negi, can you repeat? What are we going to do right now? Okay, it's fine. Okay. Please join the breakout rooms if you are in breakout rooms. Okay, Kanishka, you are in a breakout room. Please join your breakout rooms. Great. The ones who are here, I am going to share this story again with you. Okay? Didi is sharing the story again with you. You will come off mute. You will discuss. Jaise aap classes mein discuss karte ho apna normally. Didi will be quiet. Okay? Didi will not say anything. So you can start discussing. Go.
Okay, so friends, we have to think about first what will happen next in the story. So, can somebody share?
Can I share?
Yeah. So, I have written when he noticed the lion in trouble, so he will just make a joke of lion and moved away, and the lion will dead. Because I think this, because if you see in the first that time the lion made joke of mouse, so that's why I think that mouse will make joke of lion.
Can I hear?
I'm sorry to interfere, but can we also maybe start pushing our friends in asking why do they think a few questions, like, okay, so why are they ending their story like this? Please start sharing and then maybe start pushing your friends also. Okay,
can I share?
Yeah.
So mouse will ask her friends and creatures to make a circle around hunters and take one stick on your hand. Then everyone kill them and lion is in the middle. That's why.
Okay, Lakshmi, I'm so sorry. Lakshmi, I want you to pause here and think. Okay, think again. What you are reading, I think, is quite different to the story. So maybe can we have a discussion here rather than what we are reading. Okay, so pehle hum ek discuss karte hain. Okay, the way we discuss. Pehle hum ek, as a group discussion, we will discuss that I think this, I think that, and then we can come as a group, maybe solution. Ki maybe I think this could be the ending. Okay.
So friends, can I share first? Now,
yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So then suddenly Mouse think about his promise. Yeah. And then he get slowly steps and he cut the trap of the lion, and then the lion and Mouse were go and hidden behind the tree. And then lion says thank you to Mouse, and then they are always be my friends because I made this end because the mouse is he's a good friend, and he always take up promise.
Maybe you want to say fulfill his promise?
Yeah, yes, I. It's fulfilled. The mouse is always fulfill his promise. Thank you. And the next who want to say?
Can I say?
You, yeah.
The ending is like this, that when rat saw that the lion is in trouble, so rat go and chewing the net, and the lion is out and say thank you to rat.
Excuse me, you, it's lion, okay?
Okay. This answer is because the rat was promised that at one day it will also save him. That's why.
Lakshmi, go.
And why? Yeah, Lakshmi, go.
Can you please repeat, because your voice is cutting in the middle.
Didi.
Yes, Nikit Nancy. Yeah, I know Nancy, it's fun, completely fine, no problem, you can discuss here, okay, no problem.
Can I tell?
Yeah, Anya.
I think the mouse is calling her friends, and then mouse will tickling to a hunter, because in the story the mouse promised to lion, so that the lion will flee, and then mouse will also come to lion, and then lion say thank to mouse.
Anya, why do you think this?
I tell reason also, Lakshmi, because the mouse will thinking that I promise.
Okay. So I think Anya wants to say that maybe mouse will think that he has to fulfill his promise. That's why, right, Anya? Is Didi right? Okay. Thank you so much, Anya. Yes, you can go ahead with your groups. Nancy is here and Tabassum is also here. So Nancy, would you like to share what do you think will happen at the end of the story? Okay.
I think.
Yes, please continue. I'm sorry.
Didi, I think that the mouse helped the lion by the cutting leg of the hunter. And she did it because she was promised the lion that I will also help you.
Okay. So are we saying this to Didi or are we saying this to our friends?
sorry friends.
Thank you so much, Lakshmi, Nancy, for that. Okay.
Can Tabassum share?
Yeah. Tabassum, what do you think, beta? Kya hona chahiye end ki story mein? Tabassum, beta, aap mute pe hain. Okay, no problem, Tabassum. It's completely fine. I think we will be coming out of our breakout rooms and then we will be sharing this with our friends. Okay, so let's wait for our friends quickly to come back and then we can have all of us. I mean, then we can share this with our friends.
Excuse me, Didi.
Okay. Yes, Lakshmi.
Didi, we will do like that. The children who are there, they are in group. They are group.
Yeah. So they are in different groups.
Huh? Yes. So, Didi, we have to make one ended, na? We are a group. So, we will discuss and then we have to make one end.
You can Didi, go for it. It's your group. It's your call. You decide.
But, Didi, in one group, how everyone can say different? Yeah, they can say, but when we will discuss in our group, then it will...
Yeah, so when we come together, so in a group we share everyone's opinion, right? And when we are coming together, which value will it show? Which value will it show when we are coming together in a team?
Teamwork.
Great. So maybe you can think about that if you want to do that way. Okay, great. I think everyone is back here. All the kids are back. Great. Now, quickly, we will share with our friends, okay? Whatever different endings we have thought. So, first group. So, in Lakshmi's group, Lakshmi, Ridhima, Nancy, anyone can go and share what they thought about the ending. Any one of you can go. Okay, Priyanchi, please share your ending, okay?
I have written that the mouse made the joke of lion and moved away, and the lion will dead because in the beginning the lion make jokes of mouse so that he will also take revenge from lion.
Great. Thank you so much, Priyanshi, for that. Nikita, would you like to share what you discussed in the group?
I discussed that the mouse is walking, and suddenly you see a lion.
Okay.
Didi, can I tell?
Can we please wait for Nikita to finish?
Suddenly you see a lion in trouble. So, she goes forward to the hunters and she went under the clothes of hunters and she giggled hunters. The hunters ran away with them laughing loudly and when he gets time, the mouse gets time for to free the lion, he goes forward to lion and free him. And the lion appreciates the rat that I think you am really sorry. You can be friends. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you so much, Nikita, for sharing. Kashish, would you like to share what you discussed in your group?
Yes, Didi. I discussed that the mouse come and cut the net and...
Yeah, I'm listening, beta. I'm listening. You are done that the mouse cut the net and the lion is free. Done? Great. Thank you so much, Kashish. Quickly, Didi is going to take two more responses. Okay. Yes. Shreya, would you like to share what happens in the end? Shreya, beta, can you hear me?
Didi, sorry.
Okay. It's okay. No problem. I think Shreya cannot hear us. I would like Arpita to share. Arpita Negi, can you share what happens?
In my opinion, I think the story's answer where is that the rat saved the lion because I think the rat always uphold his promises.
Okay, so rat always fulfills his, upholds and fulfills his promises. Okay, thank you so much, Arpita, for sharing that. Last, I want to ask Divya, can you share what was your group discussion?
My answer is that the mouse came to the lion and he cut the net and he helped the lion because in the beginning, the rat promised that he help lion in any trouble. So like Pranchi said that he also take the revenge, but if someone was fighting us, so we will not fight with them while we can explain him that you will not laugh at someone and fight with someone, so we will not being a bad person while explaining others.
Okay, thank you so much, Divya. It was beautiful what you shared. Someone is not on mute. Okay, Ritika beta, thank you so much. Okay, now so let's quickly share. So today in this lesson, we learned how to make predictions, right? How to make predictions based on the events in a story. So story mein, if I know the events that this has happened, I can think about the end based on the events. Okay, theek hai, ye sab hua hai. So end mein maybe ye cheez hui hogi, right? So how do you think we can use this skill? We can use this skill of prediction in our life. How do you think? I want you to take quickly 30 seconds to think about this and then we will share. Okay. Thinking time first and then raising our hand.
Didi, can you repeat?
Can you repeat the question because there was a problem?
Okay. Manisha, can you repeat the question? I will share the question. Okay. On this, let me share. Yeah. Manisha, can you
see? I did not come.
Okay. What were you saying, Manisha? Beta, I couldn't hear.
Didi, I said that it was network problem. I did not hear. Can you repeat?
Yes, I will repeat. Okay, Manisha, so in today's lesson, we learned how to make predictions, right? How to make predictions based on events in a story. We know the story. Humne story padha. Humme usme events pata chale. This happened, right? And on the basis of those events, hum predictions banate hain. Ki achha, end mein shayad ye hua hoga. Right. So how can we use the skill of this prediction in our life? How will you think? Matlab hamari life jo hai, usme hum kaise is prediction skill ko use kar sakte hain? So we will take 30 seconds or maybe 15 seconds to think. And also I want you to remember, if you don't get the chance to speak, what we do, where do we write our answers? We write our answers on the chat. Okay.
Only two people. I understand the prediction.
Okay. You understood prediction, right? That's what you're saying. Great. Thank you so much, Anamika, for sharing.
Didi, I don't understand.
You don't understand? Can you wait for Didi?
Okay.
And then Didi will explain you. Okay. Okay. Thank you so much, Nikita. Okay. I want two kids to share. So Manisha, can you maybe try. Where do you think this prediction will help you in your life?
Didi, by telling something.
By telling something. By telling what?
Maybe about ourselves or anything.
About yourself. Okay. Okay.
Didi, मुझे prediction का मतलब समझ.
अनामिका आप mute हो गए हैं बेटा. एक सेकेंड रुक जाओ ठीक है लेट दिस फिनिश ओके डोंट वरी हम अभी शाम को भी मिलेंगे ना क्लास में वी विल टॉक अबाउट ओके डोंट वरी अबाउट
कैन आई शेयर
कैन यू वेट लक्ष्मी लेट मी सी ओके वैष्णवी कैन यू यस प्लीज टेल मी वेयर डू यू थिंक दिस प्रेडिक्शन विल हेल्प यू
दिस द प्रेडिक्शन हेल्प मी टू 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 दिस फॉर एग्जांपल आई हैव टू चांसेस ऑफ studying and not studying. So, this is my opinion, what I want to
do. Okay. So, okay. Great. Okay. Thank you so much for this. Now, girls, we will... Okay. Last response Didi will take. Okay. Last response Didi will take. Thank you so much, Nancy and Anya, for using the chat to write your responses, because we know that everyone cannot get the chance to share. Okay. I want Lakshmi to quickly share.
In my opinion, prediction means, like, if I ask to my friend Pihu to give me one pencil, so, and he say that he make excuses that I have no time.
She make excuses
that I have not time and like this. So then I will guess that what she want to say. So then I will know that she wants she want to not give pencils to me. So okay. This is prediction in my opinion.
Okay. Thank you so much, girls. Also, I would like, yeah, well done. We have two ways. We will choose one way. Great. That's a beautiful answer, Kanishka. If we have two ways, I will choose one way. Beautiful answers, girls. Also, thank you so much for being here. And before Didi ends her class, Didi wants to say thank you for appreciating all, matlab, each other. It's a beautiful way. And before we leave the class, I want you to remember that we always tell each other that we are kind, we are beautiful, we are smart, and we are... Yeah, you is... Okay, we'll come off mute and we will... Yeah, we are important. Thank you, Preeti, for this. We will come off mute, all of us, and we will say...
Can you repeat?
Yeah. You is kind...
You is important.
Who is beautiful?
You is smart.
Thank you so much.
You is beautiful.
Beautiful. Let's come back to our classrooms where we mute ourselves. Thank you so much. Now we will leave the class and Didi will see you at 7 o'clock in your reflection classroom. Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Didi.
Bye.
Bye, Didi. Can you end the meeting?
No, I can't end the meeting right now. Okay. I will end the meeting later. Okay.
Bye, Didi.
We'll go quickly. Okay.
Bye, Didi.
I will see you at 7. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Kashish. Yeah.
So as our students leave the lesson today, we'll just let you get to catch her breath slightly. We're going to just have a short debrief conversation between Yogurta and I, just to really hear some of her reflections on the learning of her students today. And for her to share some of the things that are enabling the learning of her students as she's made this transition from an in-person classroom to a virtual classroom. So I'm going to start with just the lesson today, and then we're going to move out and talk about the class in general. So today your students were creating story endings. What were you hoping to see today in the kind of endings that they created?
I just wanted to see, because I want my kids to build critical thinking, and I also want my kids to make informed decisions. So through this skill of prediction, I just wanted to realize that how we can, on the basis of events, can predict few things which can help us in making beautiful and informed decisions in our life. So yeah,
something that really stood out to me was the kind of connections to the text, the story that the students were making around, they're very different interpretations of what the mouse might do and what the lion might do.
Yeah.
Like, what did you really notice in their answers? Like, what really stood out to you?
I think I really noticed, I was not hoping for the funny answers. I was really hoping that they will come with maybe one answer or two answers. But one of them, two of them really shared a funny answer where they were thinking that the mouse will be kept in the pockets of the hunter. And then the mouse will trouble them. I'm quite impressed, I will say, looking at their creativity.
And why is creativity important to you? Like, I felt like you designed this lesson with space for your students, like creativity, like an opportunity for them to think like beyond what the author, like, or what the context of the story was. Like, why is creativity important to you?
For me, I think creativity really, creativity also increases your critical thinking. You think beyond, you have so many solutions for a simple problem. So creativity will also help them in the life they come from. The struggles they face. Creativity will also help them in solving their problems in a creative way, rather than cribbing about the problems. So that's why I think it's important for my kids.
Yeah, thank you for sharing that. It's a big shift from an in-person classroom to a virtual classroom. And I know that's been very challenging for every teacher that's experiencing this. Later you'll see the chat box that there were so many people just acknowledging the confidence and the culture of your students, like people noticing that like almost all your students had their videos on. We have students like celebrating each other on the chat, helping each other to read when somebody was struggling, asking each other. I noticed one of the students asking another to wait while somebody was finishing. Like, there's some really nice culture of the class. And I wondered, like, what are some of the structures that you've taken from your classroom, like your in-person classroom, and continued in online? And what are some of the new things that you're doing together as students and teachers together online?
Yeah, so for me, when I was teaching them in the school, in the physical space, the relationship that me and my kids share, it's beautiful. And I think that was missing in virtual classroom because we value physical space a lot. So that I tried to build in online classroom. So we started with doing Zumba together in the morning class, where in fact, one of my kid calls me in the morning at 5:50 and she wakes me up saying that it is a time for exercise class. And then we conduct, then we have our sessions, and then we, in the night, we do reflection, which is basically building awareness that how their actions can maybe hurt others and them also, and can make them and others feel proud about it. So setting these cultures was not me who decided. We all did this together. Also in the virtual space, we do student darbar because I really feel that right now my kids are in virtual space. They are only seeing 3 or 4 people around them. Or maybe maximum 5 to 6 people. But when they are going to come back in the physical space, they are going to, maybe they will feel underconfident because again, there will be 40, 45 kids on teachers and speaking them in front of them. So we do student darbar. And the most important thing about this safe space, I will say, and also about my kids appreciating each other, is that there is transparency between me and my kids, and there is trust and safe space that we all have created together through these structures. We also do lunch together. So we make sure every Saturday we are sitting together, and through online virtually, we literally feed each other that didi aap ye lo, aap didi ye aap khao, aap aa karo, and all that. So we do all these things together.
It's really beautiful. It's really nice to see. It's really interesting to hear the importance that you've placed and the value you've placed on that more informal space, as well as like spaces for instruction and learning, but also spaces for interaction and connection, which I think is really beautiful. I wanted to ask a little bit, like, these are grade 5 students that you're working with. Like, what has been the role that working with parents has played in terms of building the kind of culture and access and engagement to learning that you now enjoy with your students?
role of parents, right? Yeah. So I will say that my kids' parents, they are the biggest support in building this strong culture for them and as well as for me. I have always shared whatever I'm doing, the vision. If I talk about the vision where I want my kids to be, I have always made sure I'm taking them with me. We are creating a vision together rather than me going alone and making a vision or a dream for them. So I think it's a lot about teamwork. It is about sharing problems and struggles together and not forgetting to celebrate the good achievements together. So, yeah.
Thank you so much. That brings us to the close of our time together. It was a joy to be in your classroom today. I think just all of us that were what part of the audience today were just really, just felt so much joy from seeing your students' joy in their creativity, their curiosity, their care, and their love for each other and that relationship between you and them. So thank you so much for giving us a peek into your classroom, your virtual classroom today. And I'd like to just invite our audience as we close our masterclass to share in the chat box any strategy or insight that you are taking away for yourself and your work. Thank you so much.